at this juncture, and the fact of the matter has been that even as we have these conversations, President Uhuru Kenyatta, in his speech after swearing in, said that his first sort of job after that point was to start to bring Kenyans together, create a bit of cohesion, because only then would we start to talk development. Because you can't have one part of the country that says it's working while the rest is not. And if you think about issues like taxation and that sort of thing, all these things are held hostage by the political conversation. If you look at the KRA, their targets, really woeful situation there, then what do we need to get right? So that we can start to say that we don't have to be at this juncture yet again. If, as Dismas is saying, is correct, there will have to be a conversation at some point, then why not have it sooner rather than later?
I think if we listen to the president carefully, it is not a matter of lack of a conversation.
Yes.
It is which conversation are we having that's actually problematic. And the truth of the matter, that is the key question that we have to ask ourselves as a country.
Yes.
Now, if memory serves Kenya correctly, there was a point in our history where in the optimist index of the world, we came number two. Mm-hmm. That was in the year 2002.
Yes.
Now, the optimism was not held by a person called Kibaki. It was held in the idea that for once and for all, we would be able to deal with a monster called corruption.
Yes.
Okay. It is in that time when citizens stopped policemen, despite whether they were Kikuyu, Kalenjin, Kamba, Kisii, Luo, whatever it is that we were, we stood together and said, you know what? I'm not going to watch my driver bribe a policeman. Mm-hmm. We are not going to go to public office and apply for an ID card and bribe. Now, the issue about this country and what has been lost is the goodwill, not just of the political class, but also of the citizenry, to face up with the corruptness of our society. Now, we have legislated about it. We have immense laws about it. We even enacted a constitution about it, created computer programs called infamous to be able to manage how we procure things. And yet, corruption still runs rampant, not just in Nairobi, in Kisumu, in Lamu, wherever it is in this country, there's specks and huge specks for that matter of corruption. Mm-hmm. Now that monster has bred itself into the thinking that anything that is done by an institution in this country cannot be trusted. In fact, so much so that today we stand within our political parties, which misbehaved during their own nominations, and then stand by them despite the internal rot. Now,